So I can see Sonam is all set.
Yes, ma'am.
My one advice on behalf of Sonam, that whoever can put yourself on video, please do that.
Thank you.
And thank you, I think, Sonam, you can think about the phone calls that we have. When we make a phone call, we don't see the other person. Kashika doesn't, how do you modulate your voice? I mean, when you talk on the phone, we talk on the phone, we don't see anybody. So it doesn't matter whether we are on the e-technology or whether the telephone, it is the same thing that you are talking to this person on the other end. You know there is a person on the other end. That should be nice.
Yes,
it's okay. As per my watch here, it's 5.1 p.m. And here you go.
Okay. First of all, very good evening to everyone and hope you all are doing fine. And today we have to start with our first lecture. This is our first class. And we will be starting with the topic for today is environmental justice in India. So environmental justice in India, we'll start with the basic concept. We'll just, the term environmental justice in India, and just I will just share the screen with you. So if you can all see this, sorry.
Yes, we can.
Okay, I'll just put the first slide on. Yeah. Okay, so all of you can see this, the slide, environmental justice in India. Now, first of all, before I start, I would like to know what you people think about this terminology, environmental justice. What does it mean? Anybody would like to
justice that is claimed in environmental matters, like
what is the idea behind justice? What do you mean by justice? What do you mean by environmental justice rather?
Justice to our ecology.
Justice to our ecology. Only to our ecology. What does ecology comprises of?
That includes human beings also.
Human beings. So you are trying to say that the relation between the environment and human beings, in that context, you are talking about justice. Okay. Anybody else?
Like everybody has equal right to enjoy the environment,
equal
whether
right
it's rich or poor. There should not be any difference between them.
All right.
So everybody has equal right.
Okay. And anyone else?
According to me, it is a broader concept with, in which includes not only humans but animals and other ecological things also, like fishes or even the rivers. So, सबके लिए हम जब देखते हैं तो environmental justice is for all, not just for specific categories. I think.
That means you mean conservation of nature as well, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Exactly. Okay. So we'll begin with this concept of ours. So I will first, okay, I hear all of you, and thank you Abhinav, Ashok sir, and I'm sorry, Kumar Kunal. Thank you for sharing with us your ideas. Now, I would like to begin with the objectives of this session, first of all. And the objectives would be, first objective would be to study and to explain the concept of environmental justice in India. So what basically, why India? We are going to study this concept in India because environmental justice is a very broad concept and it has different meanings in different countries depending upon what factors in that particular region or country means or what is the meaning of environmental justice in that particular region. So today, what we are going to study today is environmental justice in Indian context. So this would be the main theme of our class. Okay, so the first objective of mine would be to explain the concept of environmental justice in India. The second objective would be to discuss the components of environmental justice. Now, when we will study the definition and we will go through the definition of environmental justice in Indian context, we'll try to look the components or the factors that that are affecting environment and environmental justice and that can be helpful in achieving environmental justice in India. And the lastly. To recognize the need for environmental justice, that what is the importance of environmental justice and how it is important and why do we need environmental justice. Okay, So to begin with, I would like to share two video clips with you, just to form a background and just to, you know, give you a glimpse of what we are going to discuss about and what will be the context of this class. So I would like to play the video now. Okay.
Sonam, the sound is not coming. Sound is not coming.
There's no audio.
There's no audio. Okay. Okay. I'll have to see this.
I think I have to go back to share screen, and then when you click that, there's a left, on the left side, there is a corner box which says share video sound.
On the left. Share computer sound. So sorry, I didn't know about this option. And obviously, you've used this option quite many times in the class.
No, but Jahangir taught us this.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, ma'am. I'll just resume. I'll just resume. Yeah. So I will play the video again. And
I think, Sonam, we'll have to play the video outside of the PPT.
Sorry, ma'am.
If you have a backup file of the video, play it from there.
So is it not audible yet?
No.
Even now?
No.
Okay. Ma'am, actually, the laptop in which I have...
Use VLC player. Use VLC player.
Okay, I will.
She has inserted the video in her PPT. So if you have a video, you know, this, you have downloaded this and you have the downloaded file on your computer, play it straight from there.
Yeah, sure. Ma'am, actually, the computer in which I had the file, I had to shift this PPT to another computer because, so I will just play it with VLC if it is possible. I'll just see. I'm sorry for this inconvenience caused. I'll just see what can happen. I really wanted to show these PPTs, these videos. And they're so pertinent for my... I'll just see, ma'am, what can happen. I'll just see. Just give me a minute. God. How to do that? Can anyone tell me how to download this video from here to?
You know, from the website, can you do that straight away?
Yes, I can do that on YouTube, ma'am, but it is little edited. So I've edited the video.
You just skip the part you think you can skip.
Okay, ma'am. I'll just play it on the YouTube.
This has been my lesson also, that whenever I use a video on a PPT, I prefer to keep the backup file of the video in my folder where my PPT is. So the moment you change your computers, it is always the problem. And if you have a backup file, it doesn't play here, then you can always go back to your folder and play it from there. So that's something I've learned over the years by making so many times the same mistakes, that it's playing and yours is perfectly playing. Mine hasn't played many times. But then having a backup file in the folder is always useful.
So ma'am, can you see the screen now?
Yes, we can.
Okay, so I'll play the video now. Is it audible now, ma'am?
No. When you shared the screen, did you click that again? When you shared
this, ma'am,
click this left corner share video and sound.
Okay. Ma'am, can I begin with the my lecture and I'll show you the videos later on maybe?
That's your choice.
Okay, I'll just see if it plays. I'll just see, sorry.
So just try when you're using the when you're playing this.
Is it audible now, ma'am?
No. Just check on the video link here. Is it, yeah, it's on. No, no, we are not able to hear the sound. But without the sound, is it a commentary running on the photo, on the video?
Ma'am,
no.
Not even now?
Mm-mm.
Okay. So, ma'am, I can share another video with you. It includes subtitles. So, if you can do with that. Like if few people can catch up with subtitles. Okay. Okay. I'll play another video. Share screen.
Vikha, you can't show yourself while you're lying down in the class.
Oh my God. I'm sorry. I didn't realize that it is open.
Now you're on again and you're still sleeping.
So can we start with this video? I'm sorry, it will not be audible, but you can read the subtitles maybe. So I hope you all can get a glimpse of what this video is all about, and just a little bit of understanding, I would like to tell you about what this video is actually about. This video is actually talking about the recurrent and continuous environmental harm that we are causing to the environment and nature, and because of which the resources are depleting, and we need to now redistribute this wealth and resource so that we can come together and save our planet, and again also have a balance between environment and development, a balanced development and environment. So there have been many movements which are actually helping achieve this result or this aim of environmental justice. Now I want to share with you three case studies. And with those case studies, we will try to understand the environmental harm and environmental, maybe we can say that environmental justice aspect through different components and what these case studies are about. So I would like to share with you these three case studies, which are, the case studies would be Bhopal disaster, Plachimada Coca-Cola factory, Mahan mine development. So these are the three case studies we will going to study about, and we will try to find out what happened in all these cases and what was the result ultimately, and then applying all these case studies into the definition of environmental justice and trying to understand the definition of environmental justice in that context. So the first case study would be the Bhopal disaster. So what happened in this is, in December 1984, the pesticide factory Union Carbide Corporation sorry, I just can't see this. A corporation in Bhopal, India, malfunctioned and leaked highly toxic gas into the surrounding area. More than 15,000 died and hundreds to thousands more have suffered from acute blindness, respiratory infections, pulmonary edema, liver and kidney damage and infertility. There have been little to no effort to decontaminate the groundwater and soil that is crucial to the survival of people in the area. And this led to the continued suffering and injustice to the already socially, economically disadvantaged people. The residents are still demanding action from Carbide and Indian government for their inherent right to clean water, air, and land. Now, so what are we getting from this case study is that this company which leaked highly toxic gas into the surrounding areas, which has led to major human rights violations, they have suffered health. Their health has suffered. They've been suffering. Not only that generation, even the upcoming generation is suffering. And, you know, infertility has been caused to people. And this is leading to continued injustice and sufferings to the people. And this matter has not been resolved till now. In fact, even till now, the people are asking for justice. So that hope for justice in their mind and that the legislations that are already there in our country will help them to achieve or will help them to help them so that some action should be taken against this country. And see the case, 1984 case, nothing of much relevance has happened till now. Now I would like to show you another case, that is Plachimada Coca-Cola factory. In this case, what happened is in Kerala, there is Coca-Cola bought a property to create a bottling factory within 6 months of this establishment of this factory, it was deemed polluted and unfit for the people living around there. And also what it did is the sludge and waste from the bottling factory was sold deceptively as fertilizers to the farmers, which caused harm to their health. The villagers started complaining about gastritis and stomach problems. Also, the crops of farmers were also dying because of the lack of water, because the amount of water that the factory was using, and farmers were unable to use the water for their crops. And over 80% of the Plachimada's resistance, since they are dependent on agriculture, so this was almost a community-altering problem for them, that a whole community was being suffered. Again, their rights to the environment, their rights to clean water, their rights to livelihood have been affected. So what actually happened in this case is that Plachimada Coca-Cola plant agitation, people walked out of their houses and took out a movement against them, and the residents were successful after years of non-violent protests, petitions and advocacy, and ultimately the panchayat in that area, Plachimada area, was able to effectively engage and shut the place down. So this was the result of this agitation of Plachimada Coca-Cola plant. And the third case now we will going to understand and see is the Mahan Mine Development. Now, Mahan is an area located in Madhya Pradesh, which is also a very prominent area in the India's coal belt. And this company called Isar, which is a coal mining company, wanted to establish coal mine in this area. However, the proposed mine raises environmental and livelihood concerns. If the mine would have been constructed, although it was not constructed, it was stayed, but if it would have been constructed, it would cause environmental and livelihood concern for the people in that area. Clearing the forest would have violated the religious belief of residents and would negatively have affected the jobs of 5 lakh people and would have taken grazing spaces for cattle. Now, on the other side, but if we see it on the reverse side of it, what would have happened if this coal mine would have been established? On the other side of the proposal, however, the project would supply India with another 900 tons of coal, which is crucial to the development of the nation. So what happened ultimately is that a movement was taken out by the people, which is Isar Quit Mahan project. Community activism petitions were influenced the government to block Isar from expanding into Mahan forest. And despite ongoing energy demands, which were very crucial for the development of India, the disagreement from state officials, it was shut down or it was stayed for that point of time. I'm sorry, I can't see any one of you now. Yeah, now I can see. So what we see from all these three cases, that the different aspect, if I would show you the analysis of these three cases, is that all these three cases illustrate the complexity and imbalance that has been caused between the three components. The three components would be environment, human rights, and development. That it has, there's a tug of war that is taking place between environmental, human rights, and development issues in India. And that is why it is difficult to find a balance between all these threes. And that is why what we are facing is, we are facing agitations from indigenous people, because we have to take care of everything. We have to take care of conservation. We have to conserve. We have to take care of our environment. We have to conserve our resources, our natural world. We have to take care of the human rights, so that just in the case of Bhopal gas tragedy and Plachi Mada, people were suffering, their rights were suffering. But in that case, we cannot, the development cannot overtake human rights of the individuals. So the balance needs to be, there should be a balance between all these three aspects. And the, so again, a conclusion from all these three cases would be, on one hand, it is imperative that India works to preserve what is left of its natural area, and it is crucial that people's right to land, water, and a voice are preserved, that they should have all these rights. On the other hand, it is also necessary for India to utilize as many resources as possible to meet power aims, GDP goals, and demands of a productive population. So all these factors we need to keep in mind while we are planning. And what is environmental justice? This is what the purpose of environmental justice. Broadly speaking, environmental justice is basically that everyone should be the benefits arising from the environment, and even the risks arising from the environmental decisions, should be distributed amongst everyone equally. Not one people, like the indigenous people, cannot just have the burden of all the harm that is being caused due to that developmental product, right? That developmental, what we can say, the infrastructure development, but they are suffering because of that, right? And this is where the environmental justice comes in order to strike a balance between all these three concepts, all these three aspects. Okay, so anybody who would like to ask any questions so far, and anything that someone has not understood, I need to repeat something, I need to make them understand anything else, any fact that one have anybody has missed, any questions so far? Because then we'll move on to the definition of environmental justice.
Ma'am, what is community altering?
Community altering is that it is harming the whole community. The condition and the situation of whole community is suffering. The health of whole community is suffering, and it is like the community was getting cleared because of that. And it was harmful for a community because they were suffering from health hazards. The factory was causing health hazards to them, so it would be very dangerous for their lives, and the community might just clear off in some time. So that is what community altering situation is.
Okay,
who was it? I'm sorry, I could not recognize your voice.
Anushka.
Okay, Anushka. Okay. Anybody else have any questions so far? Hope you have understood so far. Like anybody who have not understood anything so far? Okay, so we'll move on now. Okay, now we will move on to the definition of environmental justice. Keeping all these factors in our mind, let us see what can be the definition of environmental justice in India, which will serve all these purposes and which will be helpful in striking balance, and which will help us to understand the nuances that play a major role in environmental conservation and environmental justice in India. So the next slide is the definition. Now I'll first read the definition to you, and then we'll break it into the and we'll try to understand the meaning of this definition. Okay, so shall we begin? Okay.
Yes.
So environmental justice in Indian context can be defined as the practice of conserving places of natural and ecological significance. Okay, the first is conserving places of natural and ecological significance. This takes care of environmental issues. In addition to protecting the constitutional rights of citizens and encouraging individual involvement, especially among vulnerable groups. Now, as well as consistently developing industry in a sustainable way through the implementation and enforcement of policies, actions, and laws surrounding the environment. So in this definition, if you people can see, there are three main components. There are three main things that we need to focus upon. And that these are the three main components that needs to be balanced, that there has to be a balance between these three components so that complete justice, complete environmental justice be served in the society. So the first statement says the practice of conserving places of natural and ecological significance. So the first component would be conservation. Conserving our natural resources would help, would not only help us, but also our future generations, because we need to save for them also. We do not have to spend all these natural resources. Otherwise, not only for our future generations, our future generations would be affected. Later on, we are getting affected right now. Like problems we are facing. Global warming and climate change. These are threatening changes but which we are suffering from because we are not properly conserving our natural resources, right? And the next thing would be protecting constitutional rights of the citizen. Constitutional rights of the citizen, again, if we see the Bhopal disaster and Plachi and other case in which major human rights violations were there. And if we will not protect the human rights, what is the use of development if we cannot protect the life of human beings? That is the most important thing. The right to life needs to be protected first. So these constitutional rights, right to life, right to livelihood. So these are the important things that are important for serving environmental justice. So second point would be the rights of the citizens should be protected, especially the vulnerable groups. Now, who are those vulnerable groups? These vulnerable groups are those like indigenous people who are living in these areas, who are living in forest. For example, in Niyamgiri Hills, these tribes are living. They need to be protected. They are vulnerable to all these things. Because if we are to clear all these forests, we are to clear all these areas, like in case of Mahan mine development, we were talking about clearing the forest just to construct a coal mine. But the biodiversity which is already there and the people who are dependent on that biodiversity for their livelihood, they would be affected greatly. And if we will be unable, we will not be able to protect their rights, it will be drastic, because all citizens should be considered equally and all citizens' rights should be protected. Now coming on to the aspect of development. Along with this, we have to keep in mind also that developing industries in a sustainable way is also important. Sorry, ma'am, are you not audible?
Please unmute, ma'am.
I'm sorry, ma'am, yeah. I cannot hear you.
Yeah, Sona, we need to stop at this. Too bad.
Okay.
We have done 30 minutes all, and then we got left with 10 more minutes for this meeting to end. And I think we're ready for a feedback because it was a test class in any case as a beginning. So do you want to nominate?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I took a lot of time and videos also interrupted a lot of time.
It was just all good. So do you want to nominate two persons who you think will give feedback, and this should not be the same persons who have done it earlier.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Yeah. Ma'am, I would like to nominate Ashok, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to nominate Honey.
Okay, go ahead.
So sorry for the
interruption. Stop sharing your screen.
Yeah, ma'am, I'll just stop.
Ashok and Honey, are they there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Honey.
So, ma'am, first of all, I want to comment, Sonam. It was a really very good presentation.
Thank you.
All the facts which she has included in the presentation was systematic. It was a very systematic presentation. And also, one thing which I liked the most, that the presentation had limited and some important contents only. It was not something that people are not able to read over. So that was good. And the next step, when she described the cases, that was also a good thing, that she described cases with short facts and the issue which were resolved in the cases instantly. After all, when she gave the definition, because I just write down these things, that's why I'm telling you about systematic. So when you describe the definition of environmental justice, then you highlighted the main components of the definition, means where you want to emphasize upon. So those things were very good. But the only thing which I dislike was, I think that could be the problem of each of us, that is the time management. Except that I liked the presentation very much. Conversation.
The good part was about to come, but we were short of time, and I'm sorry I couldn't manage the time well. I really wanted to share the content with you. Okay, thank you.
Ashok?
Ma'am, I'm getting disconnected frequently. Adi vate mein suni nahi paya, ma'am, but it was a nice presentation. Wo to jahan tak maine dekha tha, ma'am. But uske baad main disconnect aur connect ho raha hu, so problem ye aa rahi, ma'am.
Okay. Sonam, we need a self-assessment also.
Ma'am, I think the videos did not play, and I should have taken care that I should have downloaded
those. Again, Sonam, you're starting with the negative. Start with the positive.
Okay.
All of us do this. We are doing it. We all do this. But we need to be careful, because this is the way we have to learn to give us the feedback to students also.
Okay. So what I liked about it is, yes, the presentation, the manner, the content that I gave, it was suffice.
Unmute your audio. You're making too much noise. Yes.
So, ma'am, I have given I've given concise but relevant facts only. And the thing is that I used case method. I really wanted to use video, and I used the video clips were very good. So that is what I would like to share with you, that something new, not like new. We have seen that in class, and I've learned from you only. So I really wanted to show you those videos, and I've also used animation, but that is about to come in the next slide. So, but I could not show it, and these are the positive parts. I don't know about the communication, but I tried to explain it as much as I can in the simple manner so that everyone could understand it. And again, the effects that I've put, that first line, the objectives, I have shared the objectives first so that people could understand the chronology of the slide and the class, and they could understand that what we are going to study in this lecture. The effects that I've put, again, I think font was okay. It was not too big, it was not too short, it was readable. And I was reading the slide so that somebody who is losing track of it can come back to the class and understand what I am talking about. So these are the positive things, I guess. And the negative thing, again, time management, video failure. I could not show you the other slides. I've made beautiful slides over. So... is what I think, ma'am. I really wanted to share the video, and I'm feeling very bad about it. maybe in the evaluation class, definitely I'll take care of that.
Okay. I think it was a pretty good class, and I really liked your beginning, that when you ask the students to say what do they know about it, and then also the part where you said what are my objectives. And we have been doing this, so we can certainly add, it is important to put that out there, what are the objectives. It may also be important, either for yourself, if not for the students, to certainly identify what were the learning outcomes possible from this class. So that was not, for me, certainly it was...
Ma'am, I have kept that in the last video, slide.
Okay, so, okay, great. So they've taken care of that. That's good. So the only thing I thought you could have done slightly differently, because the students may not have heard about these letter two cases, but they would have certainly heard about the Bhopal. So you said these are the three cases I'm going to talk about, these are three case studies. Maybe the same thing you had done in the first time when you said, do you know anything about it? So we could have asked the class, do you know anything about any of these cases? So some introduction could have been built in there. But I thought overall you have very good level of confidence. You were not at all floundering there. And certainly, the technical glitches we can't help. That's not something which we can handle. And this was the first time we were doing it, and we're trying to. And I think this is all technical things that we will learn over the time. That how do we ensure that when we are using the internet, then how the sound of that internet gets in? What we have learned from Jagir was that how to use the sound for the video which are playing for our computer. So certainly a lot more to learn. So all that was good, and I'm very happy with the two presentations we had today. We managed pretty well. And also, of course, you know, the time management is something we learn over the period of time. And in the examination category, time is a huge constraint. But when it comes to continuous classes, one can always manage it in the next class, what you've not been able to do in the previous class for whatever reasons. Either because the technical glitch happened, the time was lost. There were 1,000 reasons because of which the conversation went somewhere else. So there will be always leftovers. And that's okay on the regular classes. But because we are also preparing for exams, so therefore time is a major constraint at this point of time. In the classes also, it's a constraint, but not as much. So very quickly now, what's our plan of action for the next week?
We have very few seconds left.
Yes, I know. So are we meeting? Are we holding class? Are we discussing whatever is left over? What's the plan? Very quickly, only 10 seconds.
I guess we can keep a class for next week.
Ma'am, actually, I have heard a news, which is again, I think the lockdown is going to, extend.
Yes.
So like, I don't know whether we will have to have our evaluation classes on online only or in the physical mode.
We
so
can that do our is presentation
online.
We can go for online presentations.
It's working
okay,
fine.
So somebody will write an email saying who is presenting, and then I'll fix the class.
Okay.
If I hear from somebody,
I have something to offer.
There's no time left.
Okay.
We'll just get cut off any moment.
Okay.
So write down whatever. No, send emails. Send group emails so that everybody knows whatever you wanted to say, Shikhar. You can say it in the email. All right.
No, ma'am. It was just about video. How we can get the sound in video.
Send it in writing.
Right.
Okay. And thank you so much, ma'am, honey, and Ashok sir, for the feedback.